Greetings. May God bless you today. May God, my Heavenly Father, bless you today. May God, my Heavenly Dad, bless you today. May the Lord God Almighty, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, God, the Father of us who believes in Him, of us who have received Jesus as our Lord and Savior and have become His children through adoption. We are His children through adoption. We are His beloved sons and daughters. We are His sons and His, we are His boys and His girls. Blessed be God. May the Lord God Almighty bless you, my brother. May the Lord God Almighty bless you, my sister. May the Lord God Almighty bless you, you beloved children of God. May the Lord God bless you. You are loved of God your Father. You are loved of God your Father. You have a good and you have a good and kind Father. He is so good and so kind and so loving and so caring. And today I have in my heart to share with you a message on the love of your Heavenly Father for you, of your Heavenly Dad for you. I have in my heart to share a message with you, to share a message of love with you, a message to proclaim to you the love of your Father for you, the love of your Dad for you, of your Heavenly Dad for you, the love of God for you. Blessed be God. Glory be to God, our wonderful Father. He's awesome. Our Father is awesome. He's wonderful. He's so good and so kind. He's so good. We love Him. And we have all reason to love Him. Blessed be God. Glory be to God. So, blessed be God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Lord God Almighty, I pray for this person who is hearing me right now. I pray for this person, God, in the name of Jesus, Lord. And I ask you, Lord, to bless him, to bless her, to bless it, this person, God, in Jesus' name. This person, Lord, you love. This person, Lord, who is important to you. This person, Lord, whom you cherish, God. I ask you, Lord, God, in Jesus' name, Lord, to give this person a spirit of wisdom and revelation now. Into knowledge of yourself. I pray, God, reveal your love to this person, God, in Jesus' name. Lord, I pray, God, manifest your love to this person. Demonstrate your love to this person, God. Lord, I pray, Lord, make him or her, Lord, to feel your love, God, in Jesus' name. Lord, I pray, God, in Jesus' name, embrace this person, God, with your love in Jesus' name. Lord, God Almighty, Lord, show this person, Lord, your love, your kindness, your goodness, Lord, your faithfulness, Lord, in Jesus' name. Lord, I pray and ask the anointing, Lord, on this person, the anointing of your spirit, which is for your children, Lord, which is for your beloved children, God. Lord, I pray, God, in Jesus' name, Lord. Lord, I pray and ask you, Lord, in Jesus' name, Lord, to beautify this person, God. I ask you, Lord, to strengthen this person. I ask you, Lord, in Jesus' name, Lord, to fill him and all her, Lord, with love. With your love, God, in Jesus' name, and to honor this person and to favor this person, God. In Jesus' name, Lord, I ask you, Lord, in Jesus' name, Lord, I ask you, Lord, to strengthen. I ask you, Lord, to comfort. I ask you, Lord, in Jesus' name, Lord, I ask you, Lord, God, in Jesus' name, to do wonders in this person's life. To do wonders, God, in Jesus' name, and to heal, in Jesus' name, to heal and to encourage his heart, her heart, God, in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord, pour your joy, Lord, in his or her, in his or her soul, God, in Jesus' name, for the joy of the Lord is our strength. So, Lord, I thank you, God, Father, in the name of Jesus, and I believe, Lord, it is granted. I believe, Lord, you do it, and I thank you for it. In Jesus' name, amen. So, I will say to you, my brother, my sister, that because Heavenly Father loves you, because your Heavenly Father loves you, wanted to make you of it children. He wanted to make you his beloved child. He wanted to make you his beloved child. He had wanted to adopt you because he had wanted to adopt you to become his own child through adoption. He chose you, mankind, a mere creature among his many creatures, despite your sins and trespasses against him, to be favored and dignified to the point of becoming his child, his prince or princess, his own heir. Blessed be God. God loves you so much that he gave you the power to become a child of God by simply accepting his offer of adoption, which requires the acceptance of his son Jesus Christ as your personal Lord and Savior. Blessed be God. So you have become a child of God. Blessed be God. You have become a child of God, and blessed be God, you are his heir. Blessed be God, and co-heir with Jesus. Jesus, the Son of God. Jesus himself, the beloved of the Father. Blessed be God. So, blessed be God, you are loved of God. It is written in John chapter 1 verse 12. It is written, but all who received him, to those who believed in him, he gave power to become children of God, who were born not of blood, nor of the will of the flesh, nor of the will of man, but of God. But all received him. To those who believed in his name, he gave power to become children of God, who were born not of blood, nor of the will of the flesh, nor of the will of man, but of God. Blessed be God. And it is written in Romans chapter 8, starting in verse 15, it is written, For you have not received a spirit of slavery to fall back into fear, but you have received the spirit of adoption, whereby we cry, Abba, Father, Daddy. The spirit himself bears witness with our spirit that we are children of God. And if children, then heirs of God and fellow heirs with Christ Jesus, provided we suffer with him in order to be glorified with him. Blessed be God. In order to be glorified with him, with Jesus. I consider that the sufferings of this present time are not worth comparing with the glory which shall be revealed in us. For the creation waits with eager longing for the revealing of the Son of God. For the revealing of the sons of God. Blessed be God. Because your heavenly Father loves you, he gave you a spirit of wisdom and revelation, my sister. Revelation, my brother. Because your heavenly Father loves you, he gave you a spirit of wisdom and revelation into knowledge of himself, and he illuminated the eyes of your heart, the eyes of your spirit. Blessed be God, that you may know and comprehend the hope to which he called you, and the riches of the glory of the inheritance he has reserved for the sanctified ones, which is us. Blessed be God. We are the sanctified ones. We are the saints. Blessed be God. The sets apart. Blessed be God. Glory be to God. That is to say, to those who responded to his call to become his adopted children, washed by the blood of the Lamb and set apart for him. Glory be to God. Thank you, Jesus. And he has made known to you the exceeding greatness of his power that was manifested in great and beautiful way through the resurrection of Jesus from the dead. Glory be to God. So God has given us a spirit of wisdom and revelation into knowledge of himself. He has revealed himself to us, and he is revealing himself day by day to us. Blessed be God. He has illuminated the eyes of our understanding the eyes of our minds, the eyes of our spirit. Blessed be God. Glory be to God. Thank you, Jesus. And he made us understand the hope that to which he called us. Blessed be God. Glory be to God. He made us known that he has a great inheritance for us as children of God, as his own sons and daughters. Blessed be God. He made us know that we are beautiful in his sight. We are beautiful. We are princes. Glory be to God. Glory to be to God. We are of a royal family. We are of a royal family, his royal family. Glory be to God, beloved of him. We have all his affection. He loves us. Blessed be God, and we love one another. Glory be to God. This is a beautiful family we are part of, the family of God. Glory be to God. Thank you, Jesus. Because Heavenly Father loves you, He prepared a place for you in his heavenly paradise. He prepared a home for you in his holy city called the New Jerusalem. He prepared a magnificently beautiful home for you and a place, blessed be God, and a special place. He prepared a special place for you at his table, a place of a son. A place of a son, a place of a daughter, a place of honor. Glory be to God. So you have your own place. You have your own place into paradise of God, into heavenly Jerusalem, the city of God. Blessed be God. And it is written about this city in Revelation, verse 21. And I'm starting reading at verse 1. It is written, and I saw, and it was the apostle John himself, that saw that I've seen that. Glory be to God. God showed him, and it is written, and I saw a new heaven and a new earth, for the first heaven and the first earth had passed away, and the sea was no more. And I saw coming down from heaven, from God, the holy city, New Jerusalem, prepared as a bride adorned for her husband. And I heard a great voice out of heaven saying, behold, the tabernacle of God is with men, and he will dwell with them, and they shall be his people, and God himself will be with them. He will wipe every tear from their eyes, and death shall be no more, and there will be no more death or mourning, or crying, or pain, for the former things have passed away. And he that sat upon the throne said, behold, I make all things new. And he said, write, for these words are trustworthy and true. And he said unto me, it is done. I am the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end. To him who is thirsty, I will give of the fountain of the water of life freely. And he who overcomes shall inherit all these things. I will be his God, and he shall be my son. Glory be to God. Thank you, Jesus. Glory be to God. This is what God has done for us. This is what God has prepared for us. Blessed be God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you for this heavenly Jerusalem. Blessed be God. We shall dwell with God. We shall live with God. Blessed be God. And God is already with us. Glory be to God. Thank you, Jesus. Blessed be God. We are a holy nation in Christ Jesus. Glory be to God. God has taken us from all nations and peoples and tribes upon the earth. Glory be to God. Glory be to God. And God is still adding to his family. Is still adding to this beautiful family, to this glorious family, and all can come to him. All men are called to come and can become children of God. He has given to each and everyone the right and the power and the privilege of becoming children of God. You just have to believe and receive Jesus as your Lord and Savior. You just have to believe that Jesus is the Son of God. Is it the Messiah, the Savior? Is it the Lamb of God? The Lamb of God who takes away the sin of the world. You just have to believe that he was dead, that he died, and he rose on the third day. And repent of your sin. Acknowledge your sin before God. Confess your sin. And ask God to forgive you. And ask God to wash you of all the sin that is in you. Of all the filth that is in you. Because sin is filth. Ask God to forgive you of your lies. Ask God to forgive you of all wicked things you have done in your life. Of all the evil you have done. Because we have all sinned. We have all done what is wrong. We have lied. And we have cheated, and we have manipulated people. We have seduced people. We have done wrong in our lives in many, many ways. We are all sinners. Just acknowledge it before God. Ask God to forgive you of all the sins you have done, of all the wrongs you have done, of having offended God and offended your brother, your sister, your mother, your father. You have done evil like everybody else. But ask God to forgive you. Acknowledge it before God. And God will forgive you. And he will adopt you. You will become his child. Just ask him. And say, God, please forgive me. I'm a sinner. I come to you as a sinner. I acknowledge it, Lord. I confess it. Please forgive me. Save me. Give me eternal life. Make of me your child. Make of me your child. Make of me your son, your daughter. I want to be yours. And Lord, I love you. I want, Lord, to be part of your family. Please take me, God. And please, God, Lord, I pray, please, God, make your spirit to come dwell within me and to never depart from me, God, in Jesus' name. Become my own father. I want you, Lord. And Lord, I want a part in your inheritance, God. I want, Lord, a part in your kingdom. Lord, I want, Lord, to be part of your family. And Lord, God Almighty, I believe. And I receive by faith for God, you have promised it in the Bible. And Lord, I believe, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Glory be to God. Because Heavenly Father loves you. He calls you to participate in the wedding of the Lamb. In the marriage supper of the Lamb. In the wedding of the Lamb. And he called you to marry his beloved son, Jesus Christ. To be part of his son's bride, which is called the church. You will be part of the church, which is called the bride of Jesus. You have the honor and privilege to be part of the spiritual body called the church of Jesus Christ, which will rule with Jesus over the entire universe. You will have dominion with Jesus. You will have dominion with Jesus. You will reign with Christ Jesus. You will be responsible for managing and governing. Blessed be God, for God and with God. Is that not wonderful? Blessed be God. Glory be to God. So you will have dominion with Christ. You will reign with Christ. You will be responsible for managing and governing. For God, blessed be God, and with God, you will have power and authority delegated by God himself on his creation. So you will have power and authority delegated by God himself on his creation. Blessed be God. Glory be to God. This is a great honor. Blessed be God. We did not deserve that, but it is the favor of God unto us. It is the favor of God unto us. Blessed be God. Glory be to God, and it is, and we receive it by faith. Glory be to God, it is the favor of God. It is something we have not deserved. Glory be to God, and we receive it humbly. Thank you, God. Thank you, Jesus. It is written in Daniel chapter 7, verse 27. It is written, and the kingdom, and dominion, and the greatness of the kingdoms under the whole heaven shall be given to the people of the saints of the Most High. His kingdom is an everlasting kingdom, and all dominions shall serve and obey him. Is that not wonderful? And the kingdom and the dominion and the greatness of the kingdoms unto the whole heaven shall be given to the people of the saints of the Most High. His kingdom is an everlasting kingdom, and all dominions shall serve and obey him. In Revelation verse 19, verse 7, it is written, let the marriage of the in fine linen clean and white. For the fine linen is the righteousness of saints. And the angel said unto me, write, blessed are they which are called unto the marriage supper of the Lamb. And he said to me, these are the true words of God. These are the true words of God. Have you heard that? These are the true words of God. Glory be to Heavenly Father. Because Heavenly Father loves you, he even gave you a higher rank than his holy angels. Because Heavenly Father loves you, he even gave you a higher rank than his holy angels, archangels, cherubim, seraphims, a position of greater honor in his kingdom and in his government, a place of greater dignity. You are called son, daughter in the house of your Father in heaven, while they are called servants of your Father. They are called servants of your Father, but you are called a daughter of your Father. You are called a son in your Father's house and in your Father's kingdom, in your Father's government, in your Father's domain. Glory be to God. God loves you. God loves you because he has redeemed you with the precious blood of his only Son, Jesus Christ. He has redeemed you from the bondage of slavery and from the prison that Adam's sin had brought you into. He set you free from the slave master called Satan, the devil. He delivered you from the oppressors. He freed you from your chains of sin and iniquity, from your bonds. He freed you from your bounds, from your bondage, which is sicknesses, diseases, infirmities, substance abuse, alcoholism, immorality. He freed you from these bounds of sicknesses, diseases, infirmities, substance abuse, alcohol, immorality. He freed you from barriers and hindrances, which is poverty, chronic debt, depression, oppression, and fear, and anxiety, worry, and doubt, and all these, and all things like these things. Blessed be God, he freed you. Blessed be God. Glory be to God, he has set you free. Blessed be God, he has set you at liberty. Blessed be God, he destroyed these evil things. He destroyed these evil things. He gave you victory over them. Victory over devils. Victory over sickness and disease. Victory over fear and anxiety. Blessed be God. Glory be to God. Victory over poverty. Victory over joblessness. Victory over every evil. Blessed be God. Thank you, Lord. It is written in Romans chapter 3 verse 20 to 26. It is written, for no person will be justified, will be made righteous, acquitted, and judged acceptable in his sight by observing the works prescribed by the law. For the real function of the law is to make men recognize and be conscious of sin. Not mere perception, but an acquaintance with sin which works toward repentance, faith, and holy character. But now the righteousness of God has been revealed independently and altogether apart from the law, although actually it is attested by the law and the prophets, namely the righteousness of God, which comes by believing with personal trust and confident reliance on Jesus Christ, the Messiah. And it is met for all who believe, for there is no distinction, since all have sinned and are falling short of the honor and glory which God bestows and receives. Since all have sinned and falling short of the honor and glory of God, all are justified and made upright and in right standing with God freely and gratuitously But by his grace, by his unmerited favor and mercy, through the redemption which is provided in Christ Jesus, whom God put forward before the eyes of all as a mercy seat and propitiation by his blood, the cleansing and life-giving sacrifice of atonement and reconciliation to be received through faith. This was to show God's righteousness, because in his divine forbearance, he had passed over and ignored former sins without punishment. It was to demonstrate and prove at the present time, in the now season, that he himself is righteous, and that he justifies and accepts and as righteous him who has true faith in Jesus. It was to demonstrate and prove at the present time, in the now season, that he himself is righteous, and that he justifies and accepts as righteous him who has true faith in Jesus. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. Isn't that wonderful, my brother, my sister? Glory be to God. Glory be to God. You are accepted of God. You are justified. You have been made righteous. You have been made righteous. You are justified. Glory be to God. Blessed be God. There is no more sin for you who is in Christ Jesus. There is no more sin for you. You are forgiven. And you are safe and secure in the kingdom of your Father and into the arms of your Father. Blessed be God. He shall never reject you. He shall never reject you. You are safe in Christ. Blessed be God. You are saved by faith. Glory be to God. It is God's favor unto you. It is not by the keeping of the law, but it is God's free gift. Glory be to God. Thank you, Jesus. Because God the Father loves you. Because God your Father loves you. He himself paid the price for the forgiveness of your sins. Because your transgression of the law, of his law, had called on you an eternal curse and condemnation to perish in everlasting fire. But because God loves you, he paid the price for the forgiveness of your sins. Blessed be God. Because your heavenly Father loves you, he has forgiven you all your sins, your faults, your wrongdoings, your transgressions of the law. Blessed be God. They are all forgiven. They are all forgiven. All those of the past, all those of the present, and all those of the future all have been already covered. Blessed be God. They have been already paid for. Blessed be God. Thank you, Jesus, by the shed blood of Jesus. Because your heavenly Father loves you, he has forgiven you your sins, your faults, your wrongdoings, your transgressions of the law. As soon as you have repented and cried out to him for the forgiveness of your sins by accepting the forgiveness offered on the cross. Glory be to God. Thank you, Jesus. Blessed be God, through the shed blood of Jesus, the only Son of God. It is written in Romans chapter 6, verse 6-10. It is written, while we were yet in weakness, powerless to help ourselves, at the fitting time, Christ died for godly. Christ died in behalf of the ungodly. Now it is an extraordinary thing for one to give his life, even for an upright man. Though perhaps for a noble and lovable and generous benefactor, someone might even dare to die. But God shows and clearly proves his own love for us by the fact that while we were still sinners, Christ, the Messiah, the Anointed One, died for us. Therefore, since we are now justified, acquitted, made righteous, and brought into right relationship with God by Christ's blood, how certain it is that we shall be saved by him from the nation and wrath. Therefore, since we are not justified, acquitted, made righteous, and brought into right relationship with God, Christ's blood, how much more certain it is that we shall be saved him from the indignant and wrath. For if while we were enemies, we were reconciled to God through the death of his son, it is much more certain that we are reconciled, that we shall be saved. Blessed be God through his resurrection. Thank you, Jesus. Blessed be God. In Ephesians chapter 1, verse 10 to 10, it is written, In him we have redemption, deliverance, salvation. In him we have redemption, deliverance, salvation through his blood, the remission, the forgiveness of our offenses, of our shortcomings and trespasses, in accordance with the riches and the generosity of his gracious favor, which he lavished upon us in every kind of wisdom and understanding, in practical insight and prudence, making known to us the mystery, the secret of his will, of his plan, of his purpose. And it is this, in accordance with his good pleasure, his merciful intention, which he had previously purposed and set forth in him, he planned for the maturity of the times and the climax of the ages, to unify all things and head up, to unify all things and head them up and consummate them in Christ, both things in heaven and things on the earth. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. So because Heavenly Father loves you, he has reconciled you to himself by means of the sacrificial death of his son Jesus Christ. He is reconciled to you. God is reconciled to you, sons and daughter of God. God is reconciled to you. The barrier between you and him is removed. There is no more dispute. There's no more opposition. There's no more enmity. There's no more enmity between you and God. There's no more dispute. There's no more opposition between you and God. Blessing be God. Thank you, Jesus. There's no more. There's no more of these things that had arisen between you and your God due to your own sin. Blessed be God. They have been removed by the shed blood of Jesus. Glory be to God. These things have fallen down. These things have fallen down and no longer exist between you and your God. Blessed be God. In Colossians chapter 1, verse 19 to 20, it is written, For it has pleased the Father that all the divine fullness, the sum total of the divine perfection, powers, and attributes, should dwell in him permanently. And God purposed that through and by the service, the intervention of him, the Son, all things should be completely reconciled back to himself, whether on earth or in heaven, as through him the Father made peace by means of the blood of his cross. Glory be to God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you for that, God. Thank you for that, Father. Because Heavenly Father loves you, he signed a peace pact with you. Because Heavenly Father loves you, he signed a peace pact with you. He made a covenant of peace, brotherhood, and friendship with you. One sealed by the shed blood of his son, Jesus Christ. Amen. This is what God has done for us. In Hebrews chapter 13, verse 20 to 21, it is written, Now meet the God of peace, who is the author and the giver of peace, who brought again from among the dead our Lord Jesus, that great shepherd of the sheep, by the blood that sealed, ratified the everlasting agreement, the everlasting covenant, the everlasting testament, strengthen, blessed be God, complete, perfect, and make you what what you ought to be, and equip you with every good, that you may carry out his will, while he himself works in you and accomplishes that which is pleasing in his sight, through Jesus Christ, the Messiah, to whom be glory forever, to the ages of the ages. Amen. Glory be to God. Thank you, Jesus. And I pray the same for you, that God may strengthen you. Glory be to God. And now, me to God of peace, I pray, who is the author and the giver of peace, who is the author and giver of peace, who brought again from among the dead our Lord Jesus, that great shepherd of the sheep, by the blood that sealed, that ratified the everlasting agreement, covenant, testament. May strengthen you, may complete you, may perfect you, and make you what you ought to be, and equip you with everything good that you may carry out his will, while he himself works in you and accomplishes that which is pleasing in his sight, through Jesus Christ, the Messiah, to whom be the glory forever and ever. Amen. So be it, in Jesus' name. Glory be to God. Because Heavenly Father loves you, he gave you the Holy Spirit to abide with you forever, the Spirit of truth that only his adopted children can receive, the Spirit of truth to lead you in the whole truth, to teach you and make you understand things to come. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Father. Because Heavenly Father loves you, he gave you the Holy Spirit to abide with you forever. The Spirit of truth that only his adopted children can receive. The Spirit of truth to lead you in the whole truth, into all, to teach you and make you understand things to come. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. It is written in John 14, verse 16 to 18. It is written, Jesus said, and I will ask the Father, and he will give you another comforter, counselor, helper, intercessor, advocate, strengthener, and standby, that he may remain with you forever, the Spirit of truth, whom the world cannot receive, because it does not see him or know and recognize him, but you know and recognize him, for he lives with you and will be in you. I will not leave you as orphans. I will not leave you as orphans, comfortless, desolate, bereaved, forlorn, helpless. I will come back to you. Blessed be God. And he has come back. Jesus has come back. His Spirit has come back. His Spirit is himself. Blessed be God. And we know that one day he shall come back also physically. Blessed be God. He shall take us to be with him in heaven. And then he will come back upon the earth. Seven years later, according to what the Bible tells us, and we are waiting for this precious time. We are waiting for the rapture of the church. We are waiting for the resurrection, of the dead, and for the transformation of our bodies. Glory be to God. We shall be glorified. We shall be transformed. We shall be made immortal. Blessed be God. We shall be transformed and become immortal. We shall be perfected and become perfect. God himself will do it. And the dead in Christ shall rise first. They shall be raised from the dead by the power of God. And they shall be translated into heaven, into the paradise of God, into heavenly paradise, where there is a new Jerusalem. Blessed be God. And then there shall be the marriage supper of the Lamb. This feast, glory be to God, and God shall give us many rewards, many crowns of glory. Blessed be God, and God shall say to us, well done, you faithful servant, come, enter into the joy of your Lord. Blessed be God. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. I shall be there. Glory be to God. Thank you, Jesus. You shall be there. Glory be to God. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord, because Heavenly Father loves you. He wants you. He wants you to receive the power. He wants you to receive power from on high. He wants to give you the baptism of power and a purifying fire, the baptism of the Holy Spirit and fire, to strengthen you mightily in your spirit and make you powerful and strong, able to withstand the onslaught of the enemy, able to walk boldly in front of everyone, and be a good representative for your Lord Jesus, a faithful witness for Jesus, and demonstrate His love and power to the world around you. Thank you. Thank you, Lord. So I pray, if you're not yet baptized into Holy Spirit and fire, I pray that God will baptize you into Holy Spirit and fire. You need it, and it is for you, and it is very good. And I've received it myself. And thank you, God. I thank God for the baptism of the Holy Spirit. I needed it. Thank you, God. And I received it. Oh, and I rejoice. I'm so happy for the precious baptism of the Holy Spirit. It is written in Acts chapter 1, verse 8. But you shall receive power when the Holy Spirit comes on you, and you will be my witnesses in Jerusalem, in all Judea and Samaria, and to the ends of the earth, Jesus said. And in Acts chapter 2, verse 1, it is written, On the day of Pentecost, they were all together in one place, and suddenly there came a sound from heaven as of a rushing mighty wind, and it filled all the house where they were sitting. The tongues, like tongues of fire, appeared to them, separated from each other, and it sat upon each of them, and they were all filled with the Holy Spirit, and began to speak with other tongues as the Spirit gave them utterance. Thank you, Jesus, because Heavenly Father loves you. He gave you power and authority and might to cast out evil spirits in His name. He gave you power over evil spirits to cast them out, to chase them out, to send them away from you, to cast them away from people they have been tormenting. Blessed be God, because Heavenly Father loves you. He gave you power and authority and might by His Spirit to cast out evil spirit in His name, to drive out these invaders that are demons, and to release captives when they cry out to Jesus for relief and for deliverance. Glory be to God. Thank you, Jesus, because Heavenly Father loves you. He will cleanse you from your impurities. He will cleanse you from impurities in you. Blessed be God. We all have some impurities in us, and we need to be cleansed. And so, because our Heavenly Father loves us, blessed be God, He will cleanse us. He will cleanse you from impurities in you, from immoralities that you have inherited from your fathers, from your ancestors. He will wash away your sins. Blessed be God. Thank you, Jesus. Glory be to God. Thank you, Jesus. He will do much needed cleansing in you, spiritual cleansing, cleansing of your mind, of your conscience, of your reasonings and thoughts. Thank you, Jesus, for that. Thank you, Jesus, for that. Thank you, Jesus, for this cleansing, for this purifying. Glory be to God. He purifies your character and personality of what is bad. And even change your character and personality. Blessed be God, He is doing it, changing your personality and character. Blessed be God. Blessed be God. Thank you, Jesus. Glory be to God. So that you may reflect Christ Jesus, His Son. Look like Him, become like Jesus, and think like Jesus, and talk like Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Because Heavenly Father loves you, He will forgive you. He will forgive you every time you repent and confess your sins to Him and ask Him to forgive you. Thank you, Lord. Your past sins are forgiven. And if you sin today, ask Him to forgive you. He will forgive you. Blessed be God. He forgives and forgets. He forgives and erases from His books. He forgives and does not reject you. He forgives and does not reject you. He forgives and washes and restores you. Thank you, Lord. It is written in 1 John chapter 1, verse 7 to 9. It is written, But if we walk in the light, as He Himself is in the light, we have fellowship one with another. And the blood of Jesus, His Son, cleanses us from all sin. If we say we have no sin, We deceive ourselves, and the truth is not in us. If we confess our sins, He is faithful and just to forgive us and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. Thank you, Lord. Thank you for that. Because God, your Heavenly Father loves you, He will help you to forgive those who have offended you and sinned against you. He helps you and convinces you to forgive. He helps you to understand the importance and the need to forgive. He helps you to understand the importance and the need to forgive. He helps you to show mercy so that you may obtain mercy. He helps you to show mercy so that you may obtain mercy. Thank you, God, for that. This is the work of the Holy Spirit in us. Because Heavenly Father loves you, He gives you permission and the right to approach with confidence His glorious throne, to speak to Him in prayer, to fellowship with Him, to commune with Him, to express the thoughts of your heart to Him, to let Him know your needs, to ask for help in hard times, to ask Him for help in times of distress, to offer supplications and plead the cause of a loved one, to ask for and receive advice from Him, revelations of things you do not know or do not understand, to ask Him how to do certain things you do not know how to do, to ask Him for instructions, to ask Him for direction to follow, to ask Him for knowing God's plan for an important topic or a project at hand, to ask Him healing for yourself or for a loved one, to ask Him for the food you need. Thank you, God. Thank you, Jesus. It is written in Hebrews chapter 4, verse 14 to 16. Therefore, since we have a great high priest who has passed through the heavens, Jesus, the Son of God, let us hold firmly to the faith we profess. For we have not a high priest who cannot sympathize with our weaknesses. On the contrary, He was tempted like us in all things, yet without sin. Let us therefore come boldly unto the throne of grace to receive mercy and find grace to help in time of need. Therefore, since we have a great high priest who have passed through the heavens, Jesus is the Son of God, let us hold firmly to the faith we profess, for we have not a high priest who cannot sympathize with our weaknesses. On the contrary, He was tempted like us in all things, yet without sin. Let us therefore come boldly unto the throne of grace to receive mercy and find grace to help in time of need. Thank you, Lord. Because Heavenly Father loves you, He enjoys communion. He enjoys communion with you. He enjoys your presence and loves having you with Him. He's pleased when you come near Him and open your heart to Him. He's happy. He's happy when you trust Him and talk to Him, when you put yourself at ease with Him. There's no discomfort or shyness to be between you and Him. There's no discomfort or shyness to be between you and Him. But feel confident with your heavenly Dad. Feel confident with your Heavenly Dad. Have with him this same intimacy a husband has with his wife, a fiancé with her fiancé, a very best friend with his closest and best friend, a small child with his beloved daddy he loves so much and whose arms he rests in peace. Blessed be God. So you see, Heavenly Father loves you. Your Heavenly Father loves you. Your Heavenly Dad loves you. Your Heavenly Daddy loves you. You are loved. Believe the love. Receive the love. Let Him love you. Blessed be God. Receive His embrace. Thank you, God. Receive His affection. Blessed be God. And give Him all your affection, all your love. Thank you, God. Thank you, Jesus. So may God bless you. Amen.